Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth series. We've got ourselves quite the little streak now, don't we? Yeah, 23, I will take it. And we're just gonna hope that we keep on going. That's the plan anyway. Let's see what kind of start we get. Oh boy, Isaac's Heart, Satanic Bible, Curse of the Unknown. It doesn't get any worse than this. Saving grace here will be Satanic Bible. Obviously taking the pill is probably not something we're gonna do. We also get Interdimensional Baby from the item room. This is about as nightmarish as it gets. In fact, it doesn't get any more nightmare than this. Again, the one thing that we've got going is the fact that we've got, we do have the Satanic Bible. Now, what are we thinking here? Because this is an item that you probably have never seen me play with before. And by that, I mean I'm referencing Isaac's Heart. What are we playing for? A reroll. Just straight up reroll. Again, I would say I'm in the entertainment business, but I'm also, more importantly, I'm in the winning business, and I want to keep the streak alive, and I'm going to fight like hell to make sure that we can do that, but there's just certain starts that are almost cursed. So what is Isaac's Heart, and why does everyone hate it? Well, why do the majority of people hate it? The answer is quite simple. Isaac's Heart is the only part of Isaac's body that can take damage. Now, I know that sounds pretty neat, but trust me, it gets worse. The problem with Isaac's Heart is that it will trail behind Isaac and basically make it to where the hitbox for Isaac is basically walking behind him. Now, luckily, we don't have another familiar, and Isaac's Heart is not going to be that far away from our body. It could be worse, I guess, in a weird way. If you think about it, because Isaac's Heart, if it's trailing behind you, like say it's like even the second or even third familiar that's behind Isaac, that is a long, long, long way to be trailing the only party that's vulnerable of your body behind you. So we're fortunate in the fact that we do have, at least it's closer to our body, but we still have to be extremely careful. A trinket like Child's Leash, would be kind of one of their, yeah, see, we get hit there, and it doesn't seem like it would be that... Oh, almost got hit again. It doesn't seem like it would be that big of a problem, but it is. Because, especially after... Even with someone like me who's played the game for, you know, thousands of hours, you get kind of used to knowing where your hitbox is. And Isaac's Heart is... It throws all that off. I mean, it's just... It's really hard to keep your eyes focused on where Isaac's Heart was. Or is, I should say. So, yeah, we're going for a reroll. You have to sidestep everything, but you need to do it quickly. Now, movement speed is essential, even more so with Isaac's Heart, because you've got to get out of the way of shots. And the enemies are not going to be nice. They're going to be... These Diglets are... They are tuned in right for Isaac's Heart. They're not zoning in on Isaac's body. They're going right for the heart. Again, the only saving grace that we have here, the only way that we possibly will be able to get through this is going to be the Satanic Bible. But obviously we're going to be playing for a reroll. I mean, if we can get a one room, if we can get the D100, D4, I don't care, man. We got to get that. We get small rock, it's going to be great. It's not exactly what I really wanted, but I'll take more damage. And yeah, this is quickly already becoming, you know, a very dangerous situation for the streak. I will do my best. Oh yeah, on top of that, having the Curse of the Unknown as a start is also kind of lame. I mean, the game is firing on all cylinders as far as the troll factor is concerned right now. Get another bomb. There's another Tinted Rock here. Don't expect this to be a short run, unless we get a reroll that gives us, like, you know, Dr. Feeders or something. This is going to be one of those runs that we are just going to take our time and try to win. I don't have a very high winning percentage with Isaac's Heart. I will admit that right now, because it's an item, obviously, that I've only... the only time I've ever used Isaac's Heart is if I re-rolled into it, or if I, like, I just had to pick it up just to get the unlock. So, yeah. We are going to get a Soul Heart here. I'm going to save this other bomb for the Golden Rock. Or the, not Golden Rock, but the Golden Chest that is locked within the rocks over here before the boss battle. Just trying to get as many advantages as possible before we go into this. Actually, we're not going to have enough bombs. You know, we'll save the bomb. We'll go ahead and save the bomb here and see who we're fighting. It's going to be Ragman again. And this is not going to be a fun fight for Isaac's heart. So the trick with Isaac's heart is training your eyes to not look where Isaac's body is, but pretend that Isaac is the little red dot that's trailing behind your body. That's the only thing you do. Now, something else I should say that we do have working for us is that our damage is quite good. Even before we got Small Rock, our damage is good. We have a good fire rate. Our movement speed could be better, but it could be worse. So I'm interested. Ooh, we got Latchkey, which is going to give us another Soul Heart. I'm interested in seeing how much HP we have. I'm going to try to make it work. If you're good at this game like NL or Lethal Frag are, like, you know, this is not really that big of a deal. But for me, it's kind of a big deal. Oh my goodness, we have a ton of HP. Okay, that gives me hope. That gives me a little bit more hope. I'm still not feeling good about our situation. We just lost one of our Soul Hearts there. Interdimensional Baby is going to be kind of a help if we can stay still when we zone into a room and not get hit. All right. So there goes another Soul Heart. Yeah, the game is... Game is not playing nice right now. We're gonna try to make it work anyway. And yeah, we can just walk and lose another Soul Heart. That's fine too, you know. Just completely contradict everything that I've been saying for the past 30 seconds. That's fine. It doesn't need to be said, but I'm gonna say it anyway. I absolutely hate Isaac's heart. I don't know anyone who is a regular Isaac player who enjoys Isaac's heart. Because it's so unwieldy and it's so wonky that it's just not worth the risk. There is literally the only upside to Isaac's heart is that you can play blood banks indefinitely and you're not affected by like traps and stuff, because since Isaac's heart is flying, you're not technically hitting it. So curse rooms and all that stuff are fair game. You cannot use self-sacrifice rooms though. The sac rooms will still hurt you. And we get directed tears. No. On top of having to worry about Isaac's heart, I am not worrying about where my mouse cursor is. Where we're firing at. This is not happening. That's about some of the cheapest damage we could have ever been inflicted with there. There's a tinted rock here, thankfully. Our goal is to survive. Head of the Keeper is fine, I guess. There's a steam sail in here, which I would like to get. I would also like to get this full charge and the soul heart. So we are. I'm again telling you right now, this is going to be a long run. We're doing everything in my power to make this run not a loss. So we're going to take the steam sail. It should be enough to buy the. Both of these. So we get a soul heart, we also get a full charge. It's actually a big waste of a full charge there. What I should have done is cleared to get the charge on the Satanic Bible and then picked up this full charge. That was a misplay. A quite big one at that as well, because I just cost myself an extra soul heart. So this sucks. Thankfully we didn't get hit by it. The key. I'm not gonna beat around the bush. I'm deathly scared of this run, but I'm gonna try to make it work. These are the type of runs that you gotta win to keep streaks, and you know it's our time to be tested, I guess. Although that last episode, the episode entitled Clinch, was also kind of a big test. I'm not gonna take any pills again. I feel that would just be nonsensical at this point. Ooh, almost got hit there. Knockback, like getting Pisces, Small Rock does have an inherent small knockback associated with it. It's very, very important for Isaac's heart. I mean, I'll be honest, like, it would be nice to get a win with Isaac's heart just to show, like, you can do it, even someone who's not technically as great as the game, like me. I would love that. We get Juice's Shadow, which does not reroll Isaac's heart, but it gives us an extra life, which is something that is going to be very beneficial. So we are not, I repeat, we are not activating, we're not going to turn into Black Judas here. We cannot waste this heart. But we also get a Maw of the Void. It gives us an extra soul heart generator, which is something that we desperately need. And we have Deal with the Devil precedent. So, you know, it could be worse. And we get the Pact as well, which is going to give us even more damage and more soul hearts as well. So this is good. So there's the free curse room entrance. Again, since Isaac Hart technically, this is real bad. Yep, absolutely nothing I can do in this room. Or yeah, they're just gonna take another soul heart. Okay, we need to settle down here. That's how quickly it can turn around with Isaac's heart. We need to chill out. Let's take it slow. Let's not go getting on tilt level here. Just because we have an extra HP, just because we have one life and good damage now, does not mean we get to relax. I'll relax when this run is over. Yeah, we don't care about that. The early Steam sale is huge, because if we get a greed fight, and the second greed fight gives us, oh my god, I need to stop getting stuck in this corner. If we get another Steam sale, that basically makes everything from here on out free in the shops. And since we got it so early, that means that we have a very good chance of doing so. Again, we need to take every liberty we can to make this a win. We get the D20, which is not what I wanted. It's interesting, but the Satanic Bible is far and away the better choice here still. Usually the secret room's right there, but we don't have a bomb, so herp-a-derp-a-derp-a-derp. I can actually walk over these spikes, by the way. Again, the spikes don't matter for Isaac's heart. One of the only benefits to having Isaac's heart. Thank you, Interdimensional Baby, for making this possible. Got more bombs. Obviously, I would like to get in there with Maw of the Void and get some more HP. But we're not going to be risky. We're just going to take it as it comes. We get the Fallen on floor 3, which is also kind of a shocker. Let's see if we get in with Maw of the Void. We are going to take a hit, as to be expected. And we get High Shadow. Well, we've got Judas and Upside Down Judas, so. With runs like these, you gotta win one room at a time. That's how it goes. You gotta do it. I'm not gonna pick up that full charge yet because there may be a shot of us. Well, we also have to get to the store. The shop could have another full charge, so I'm not going to do the mob trap room unless I absolutely have to. It looks like I'm going to have to if I want that full charge. Actually, no, the full charge isn't even going to matter. So, what's funny about this is my shadow will actually give us a little bit of help here as well with the counterattack grubs that we spawn. But of course, that's predicated on us taking hits, which is not something that is ideal. Compass is going to be nice here. It's going to help us to not get off center here. Tower card is not what we want. I mean, I'll hold on to it, but yeah, we don't want the tower card. Might be able to use it for a boss. The secret room is not there. It has to be to the right of this room. There we go. And there's nothing. Fantastic. Again, Steam sale paying off here, giving us the compass is very, very handy. It keeps us safe. It makes sure that we can focus our efforts in going the right direction, especially if we don't have any time or HP to waste. So we're doing it. I'm trying to think of ways to be entertaining while also going into tryhard mode here, but when it comes down to it, I'll do anything I can to win. Curse the Blind, I don't really relish in that sense, but or this idea of having Curse the Blind here. You get a Demon Judgment. We're of course not going to play it. I'll blow it up. Assuming we don't get like an Algiz Rune or something, I'll blow that up to increase our deal with devil chances. Obviously, we did not get a deal with devil on the last floor. Magic Fingers is a no help. The only thing good about getting my shadow is that it takes it out of the deal with the devil item pool. That's one less garbage item that we're not going to see in the deal with the devil. So, what other items are we looking for, assuming we can't reroll? Something like the relic would be great. Something like Dark Bum would be phenomenal. Anything that gives us HP, extra lives, of course, is going to be nice. And damage. I mean, if we can get a hard carry item, you know, I'll take it. Mom's Knife, Brimstone, Ipecac, Dr. Fetus, probably? Yeah, I probably would take Dr. Fetus. I would not take Epic Fetus, though. That's disaster waiting to strike. No greed fight. I am surprised. We get the blue candle and glowing hourglass. So both of this was a waste. There's also that full charge, which we can turn into an HP, of course. This is a big floor. This is not... Yeah, this is Curse the Exile. Or Curse the Blind. We know that the secret room is right here, because it always is to the left of this room. Ooh, another full charge. That's beautiful. Okay, so this is 2 HP that we can get here. We can even get ourselves another nickel from this keeper. Just gotta be careful of the... Yeah, by the way, it's not guaranteed that you get a nickel from that guy. It's usually... It's almost guaranteed. Again, we're gonna do our due diligence here, making sure that Isaac's heart is out of the range of our opponents. Alright, it's time to cash in our HP here. Get 1 HP, 2 HP. It's going to come down to the Satanic Bible and us being able to generate more HP than we lose. Bottom line, that's how you want to... If you're again, not all that great at a game like this, that's how you want to run like this, is if you just outlast... Don't take any risks and just outlast the amount of damage that is incoming. You can do that, you should be fine. I would love to see Dark Bum. Which, taken out of context, sounds really weird, but that's okay. I don't care. At this point, I'll say anything we can to get this win. A range upgrade would be stellar. As you can see, we've taken some shots here because we've had to get so close to our enemies. And that's hurting us in the long run. We've got plenty... Well, we don't have plenty of bombs. Let's use the tower card to see if maybe we can get a lucky strike on these mushrooms. Or they could just all, like, stand right there. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine, too. Liberty cap? Sure, I'll take it. Again, I appreciate Interdimensional Baby being there for us in this time of need. Okay, there's another HP sitting here waiting for us after the boss fight. Which is good. I'll go ahead and take this. I'm not going to take the full charge quite yet. It's going to be hollow. There's literally nothing I could have done there. We still get the Deal of the Devil anyway. It's probably going to be Krampus. We get Mom's Underwear. Hey, it's range. One of the few times I'm happy to see a range upgrade. We needed that range upgrade. And Krampus is just not going to fight, apparently. That's fine. It's going to be Lump of Coal. It's fine with me. So, good things are happening. I don't think it's worth us continuing this floor. I could go fight the boss trap room in hopes of getting Cricket's head. But we could also get Bob's brain. Curse the Blind, I'm not going to risk it. I'm just going to be safe and minimize the amount of risks that we can take on this run. Playing to win. That's all we're doing. We're just playing to win. This will absolutely open. Lots of money. We got a golden key. It's good. Almost got hit there. And we got hit there anyway, so. Something like the wafer would be nice. As you see here, all the enemies are... They home in on Isaac's heart because they know... I mean, the game is programmed to not care about the body. We finally get a... We actually do finally get an HP from Maw of the Void. So thanks for paying out finally, Maw of the Void. Don't mean to be a little... ungrateful there, but we are kind of in a pickle here. We only lost 2 HP so far. Rooms like these are our best friends. Unless if I just walk into a fly shot like that, then they're not. We need more movement speed. No. Explosivo, I don't think so. I don't know why NL calls it Explosivo. That must be a Canadian thing. I call that Explosivo. Whether it's right or wrong, I'll leave it up to the internet to decide. Satanic Bible again coming up in the clutch. Curse Room. Full charge? No full charge. We got a Hermit card, a World card. Go ahead and use the World card. We'll keep the Hermit card. And this gives us an opportunity to port out of the boss trap, the boss rush if we need to. Another full charge over here, actually, which is fantastic. And we get Head of the Keeper, which will give us HP, or not Head of the Keeper, Fate. I don't know why I keep calling that Head of the Keeper. So Fate is nice because it gives us flying. I'm not a huge fan of getting the Eternal Heart here because we're going to need Polaroid Invincibility. Oh, Temperance will give us a, all right, never mind. I believe that this gives us unlimited money, though. Yeah. If only we had the D20 now. But I'm not going to take the IV bag over Satanic Bible. That's just silly talk. So we're going to play this and buy everything we can in the store. It's probably going to be greed, though. Excuse me, Isaac. I don't know what happened there. That was weird. I hope they didn't corrupt my video. Please don't corrupt my video. This is not a run that I'm going to replay. Alright, OBS seems fine, so I don't know what happened there. I've been having, like, issues with the latest beta... Not beta drivers, but with the latest NVIDIA drivers. I might as well get 99 cents. And also, maybe Magic Mush? Maybe Magic Mush? Maybe nothing. Fair enough. Alright, we're 99 cents. We can buy anything that we need. We've got more HP here. Lucky Poop would have been nice a couple floors ago, but I think we'll stick with the Liberty Cat because we could proc Magic Mush and Skinny on Mushroom. And I realize I'm not doing my due diligence by utilizing Maw the Void better. But that's because we kind of have more things to worry about other than just landing Maw the Void here and there. I'm not trying to make excuses for, you know, for laziness. It's just I'm prioritizing staying alive and minimizing damage over, like, trying to get, like, an optimized hit with Maw the Void. I mean, yeah, we could get a Soul Heart, but we've also got the Satanic Bible. Not worried about Soul Hearts right now, which is a luxury that few can say on a run that has Isaac's freaking heart. So I'll save all the coins on the floor in case we do actually get a D20 or Dice Shard or something like that. It's going to be greed. Still got hit. And we get a second Steam Sale, so now money really doesn't matter. Unless we go do Hush, which... that's funny, Internet. Yeah, there's... Our movement speed is just terrible. Movement speed is our biggest weakness right now outside of having Isaac's heart. Well, we got full charges to repair the damage here. And we also have another Red Heart HP coming, so we're okay. I'm not going to go back and get that full charge unless we need to. But having Fate is huge. Again, Fate allows us to be a little bit safer with our shots. Now if we get something like Spectral Tears, this is actually great because this will allow us to shed the Red Heart HP we got from the Eternal Heart, assuming we get a deal with the Devil here, which we should. This will allow us to get rid of the Red Heart, and we can go back and fill up our slots with more Soul Hearts here. We got Brownie, this is going to be just a nightmare of a fight. I'm just going to try to bum rush him down with Maw of the Void here, because we are not going to be able to avoid damage here. Just mitigating as much shots as possible. Thank you, Maw of the Void. This is also a good attempt for us to get some retaliatory HP, thanks to the fact of all the adds they spawn. We get the matchbook. It gives us another Soul Heart. We only lost 1 HP total on that. Deal the Devil's going to be Dark Matter, which I guess I'll take. Doesn't really matter. It's damage. I'm not a huge fan of the fear, but the fear, in a weird way, kind of keeps us safe. Okay, we're going to go back. We're going to clear off one more room, get the full charge. Or use the Satanic Bible, get a full charge, and then use the Satanic Bible again. Didn't need that key anyway, even though we have a golden key. Spectral Tears or Piercing Shots are really going to be premium right now. Alright, there we go. So we're going to be at a full rack of HP here in a second. And now it's painfully obvious how slow we actually are. Right now, realistically, if we take a step back and remove all uncertainties that we have about this run, if we just observe and count the good things versus the bad things, we have more good than bad going on right now. We have a readily available way of creating more soul hearts, or at least giving us a chance to get soul hearts. We've got good damage, and we have flying. There's more good than bad happening. And I think that having a positive outlook on a run that's like this, that's scary like this, is essential. So we still have this Hermit card, and I think that's a good opportunity for us to steal the item out of the boss rush. Boss trap, I should say. We've already missed boss rush, and there's no way we're going to do boss rush. So there's a chest there. Let's see what this is. It's going to be the 4 golden chests that I did not take on the last floor. I don't want to pick up the Eternal Heart at all. Mask of Infamy is fine. And yeah, so this was a big old waste of time. But we get free BFF. We get free more options. All right. We can go ahead and put some of this money that we've taken back in the bank. So we're okay right now. And we still have an extra life. That's another huge opportunity for us to recover should something catastrophic happens. I'm not trying to create more drama than it is. I'm expressing how tense I am right now with this run. It can go quick. The amount of HP that you have with Isaac's Heart can be expended quite alarmingly fast. And especially given the fact that we do not have any movement speed, this is a big, big challenge. I don't think we're gonna be able to get by this. Let's take one spike wall at a time. They're not gonna activate off of Isaac's body. They're just gonna activate off of the heart. So there's no way that we can get in, out of there with our movement speed. It's unfortunate. We gotta just not lose more HP than we can gain. Kane's Eye doesn't really matter. I'd still prefer to have Liberty Cap. Your chest. We've got a good amount of utility items here as well with the bombs and keys. Do we play for the blood bag? I actually think yes at this point. It's very likely we'll get another opportunity to get rid of the red heart here. So getting a blood bag, it gives us a slight speed up. It gives us HP. You know, I'm willing to call that a good play. You can see how just abysmally slow we were. So anything that improves our speed is a good get for the team here. This is Maw of the Void written all over it. Got the third one, very nice. And the Maw of the Void damage is certainly nothing to sneeze at. We've got it. It scales off of Isaac's tier damage, so it's doing a good amount of damage here. By the way, thank you, Infamy, for saving us that one shot. We appreciate that. All right. Beautiful job. Another Soul Heart, which we can't get. It's good to know that it's there, though. We got Little Haunt and a book, or Telepathy for Dummies, which obviously we are not going to be taking. I mean, Little Haunt doesn't really help us. It's more damage, I suppose, if you want to look at it in a weird oddball sort of way, but it's nothing I'm really too keen on right now. It doesn't affect us in any way, let's put it that way. All right, we've got a full charge. We've got HP. We didn't get a whole lot of movement speed. Ideally, we could get a speed upgrade on the next floor. I'm hoping that we could get something like... can we go around? We can actually go around there. I take my sarcastic quip from earlier back. Ideally, something like growth hormones or speedball would be amazing. Just wanted to check in here. There's actually a thorn chest in here, which I've never... Will this affect us? No, we can actually hit it. Fair enough. I'm learning a lot about Isaac's Heart right now, which is not something I thought I'd ever say. Secret room's probably above here. It was a shame that we only got one store advantage out of having double steam sale, but oh well. Lumber coal helps us a lot. That Soul Heart will replenish our HP. Still have the full charge. Alright, let's go back and... was there a full charge in the shop? There was not. That was terrible. To start taking pills, but I'm not going to. Also, where did that full charge go? I thought there was a full charge somewhere over here. It was in the boss trap room? No, it's an eternal heart. It's in the curse room. That's what it was. It was a regular soul heart in the curse room. Oh, there's the full charge I was waiting for. Fair enough. Might as well get this key. No reason not to. Okay. We're probably going to lose the soul heart that I just picked up from the trap, from the spikes anyway, but we'll get there when we get there. All right, let's take it easy here. We can go up and over the first one. Yeah, whatever. I'm hoping that we get Speedball, Synth Oil, not Synth Oil, but Roid Rage. There's a syringe, but the wrong syringe. I forgot that we got BFF, so Lil Haunt actually will deal a decent amount of damage. I don't think BFF modifies interdimensional baby's damage anyway. Did not get a deal with the devil, which is disappointing to say the least. Oh, there was a Tinted Rock up there that I just realized we missed. That's okay. That's all right. It's okay. Really wish we had Spectral Tears. Thank you, Lil Haunt. You're doing your part. That's all we could ever ask from you. Curse the Unknown's a little bit mean, but we know exactly how many shots it takes for us to get killed. It's going to be 12. No secret room up there. Interesting. No Tinted Rock in this room. Let's go see what's in the curse room here. I'm happy that it's Curse the Unknown and not Curse the Blind. Or Curse the Lost. Curse the Lost would also be pretty bad. Alright, the boss room's up there. We might as well go check out the mob trap room. It might be three red chests. I really hate the lack of movement speed we have. It is not three red chests. Fair enough. No reason to get comfortable right now. No reason to get complacent or cocky by any means. I'm talking myself up here. We can do this. Come on, man. Alright, I think we're back at full HP right now. Secret room's definitely up here. No, it's not. Well, I guess I just don't know anymore. And this isn't even the right way to go, so that sucks. Thank you, Maw the Void. Maw the Void being an all-star right now, even though it's not producing us any HP, but it's helping us get over our lack of piercing shots. We have two playing cards, Joker card and two of spades. We'll hold on to the Joker card and possibly ride that card all the way to the cathedral. Yeah, there's nothing I can do. Full charge. Let's see. We should have enough rooms to make that full charge work. Surprised we didn't get hit there. So you don't actually have to kill those floating red skulls. They'll die if you kill everything else in the room. I'm just going to give up on the secret room. I have no idea where it is. Ah. Let's go back and get this other soul heart, or this other full charge here. I'm thinking about not using it, but I think we're missing one. I'm not gonna use the soul heart just in case. Like, I don't want to waste it. Triacted's not really a great fight for us, but we're able to make it work. We got Magic 8 Ball, which is speed up, which is a shot speed up. We got double Joker card, and we get Brimstone. Thank you, Stanley. Words cannot explain. I can't pick it up. Why did it not switch over to Soul Hearts? Joker. You gotta be kidding me. I meant to pick up Brimstone and I didn't pick it up because we don't have red arts. That is a we have to look for any, I guess, double Eternal Heart now. I can't believe that happened. So I thought, and I'm still not quite sure why it didn't do it, but I was expecting Brimstone to switch over to Soul Hearts after we picked up the Sack Dagger. For some reason, it didn't. And I was more than happy to take Sack Dagger. Sack Dagger, realistically, is still okay, but obviously I would have far and away wanted Brimstone. But hey, the only thing that I will say about this, because it's not a good idea, and I'm not too happy with myself right now, but the only thing that's good about this is that you guys and gals can't say, well, we got built up by Brimstone. We're going to have to earn this one. I will take a double Eternal Heart, though, and I'm going to look for it. We're doing it the hard way, I guess, so that's fine. I have no idea how much HP we have. Well, I know that we just lost one there. Yeah. Man, that sucks. I thought that taking the Joker card the second time around would have switched the cost of Brimstone, but apparently it didn't. Alright, well, we're not making it easy on ourselves. But all things considered, Sack Dagger is still fantastic. We did get rid of our Red Heart, which means that we are going to have permanent Polar Invincibility. On top of that, we have Sack Dagger, and Sack Dagger does a nice amount of damage. Obviously, Brimstone would have been nice, but I'm a dummy, so. And there is a dice room here, too. Now, the question is, at this point, would I re-roll the run? I think the answer is yes, because, well, if I re-roll the run, then I get rid of Judas's Shadow. I don't know. It's a weird call that we're in, because we have game-winning damage right now. I think that we can win with what we have, even though it's Isaac's Heart. At this point, it's gone beyond meme level. I think we can win with what we have without having to re-roll. Early on, I would have definitely re-rolled, but now I'm not so sure, because I don't want to lose my extra HP, or not my extra HP, but I don't want to lose my extra life here. That could be a game changer. Yes, we would be able to possibly turn into Black Judas, because I don't believe that Judas the Shadow gets re-rolled, but I don't know for sure. I don't believe, now that I think about it, permanent Polaroid invincibility actually affects Isaac's Heart. You saw how quickly we just lost 2 HP there for literally nothing, so. Do I re-roll or not? That is the question. Would have been so much easier if I just took Brimstone. Oh, that's a blunder of the year so far. We got 2 curse chests, okay. We got Gimpy, the nail, and the shovel. I'm gonna take Gimpy here only because it gives us a chance at turning around more soul orbs. And actually, we basically almost break even on that, so. Gimpy will give us a chance to recover a soul heart when we inevitably take damage. Like that. Yeah, we'll definitely take Safety Scissors. That's nice. Safety Scissors will take a Troll Bomb and turn it into a regular bomb. And a Mega Troll Bomb will also get turned into a double Troll Bomb. There's Goat Head, which is just laughable at this point. And Fate's Reward. So I find it hilarious that we got a 2 room, but we can't re-roll anything. Like, just because they're on the floor does not matter. Yeah. I mean, Head of the Keeper is fine, or Fate's Reward rather is fine because it does give us another follower, and we do have BFF. Yeah, I mean, we're not going to get a reroll unless the D100 or D4 is in the chest, which at this point is a possibility, but I almost kind of want to do it straight up the way that we're doing it now, just to say, you know, oh, I've got Isaac's Heart's win on Eden Run. I mean, we're getting semi-bailed out here by the Satanic Bible. Actually, who am I kidding? It's been all the Satanic Bible. Maw of the Void has been helpful, but not instrumental in this run so far. I don't even see Isaac's Heart right now. I have no idea where Isaac's Heart is, but that's a little scary. We should not have lost 2 HP in that room. I'm also a little bit sad that Gimpy hasn't paid out yet, but it is what it is. I think Isaac's Heart is right behind, or right on top of Fate's Reward, which is kind of a bad thing, but I guess in a way kind of a good thing, because Fate's Reward's model is slightly bigger than Isaac's Heart, which means that it helps me keep track of its position a little bit easier. Ooh, that was such a nice soul heart drop. Or not soul heart drop, but full charge here. We're going to take damage on this. Just get out of this fight. That's all we got to do. Sack Dagger, you're beautiful. Sure wish there was a deal with the devil that had brimstone in there. I'm not going to live that one down for a while. Alright, Curse the Maze, which is hilarious because it gives us a chance to waste our Joker card. You can use a Joker card on Curse the Maze and not get teleported to the Deal with the Devil room. It's happened before. To me, specifically. Our movement speed is still god-awful. I guess Polar Invincibility is infected, or Isaac's Heart is affected by Polar Invincibility. I did not see that spider at all. Come on, Gimpy. A little bit of help here would be nice. Okay, we bum rush those down. Thank you, little Haunt, for doing something. Full charge, please. No full charge. I'm not going to get greedy with Maw of the Void. I can't. Well, actually I can, because I can use the Joker card to get out of here. Blue Larry Jr. will drop a soul heart. Okay, there it is. Get out of here. Just get out of here. Empty Vessel might be big. And Guppy's Collar doesn't necessarily help us right away, but it gives us another option to get out of this. So, there you go. This is basically what we're rolling with now. An Emperor card would be beautiful. If we get an Emperor card from Sloth, we win the run. Because we can take this. I have no doubts that we're going to be able to beat Isaac. I'm scared about the journey in the chest. And if we can get an Emperor card just to skip all that stuff, we can get out of this run and win the game. It's a Hangman card. That's not exactly what I wanted there, game. No Tinted Rock in here. There's usually almost always a Tinted Rock in that room. Fistula is a terrible, terrible, terrible room to be in. Yep. Literally nothing I can do about that. Not with this movement speed. There was not another full charge on the floor that I can see. Come on, Monstro. Be cool, man. I don't feel good about this. I really don't. I don't know why I thought I'd be able to block the shots from Isaac. We're gonna take hits. We just gotta burn them down. Our movement speed is abysmal. Oh my gosh. We could... Do we clear... No. We just go for it. Oh man, this is gonna come down to the wire. If we lose the streak, it's because... It's because I could have picked up Brimstone, but didn't. Lazarus's wrappings, ugh. I mean, it gives us another HP... It gives us another life, but man, oh man. I can't take... I cannot take Thunder Thighs. Our movement speed's already slow enough, and that would kill our permanent polar invincibility. But one thing I will say about Thunder Thighs is that if for some reason we do lose our life, which is probably going to happen, that gives us a way to get more HP back. So that shouldn't have gone off. Safety Scissors, I believe, should have stopped that. And then, of course, we're getting, like, nothing but lust on the way there. It's great. The one like, boss that we can't outrun. Oh, the D8. The D8 might give us movement speed. Dear God, give us movement speed. Our movement speed's even slower. You gotta be kidding me. But our tears rate is incredible. Double brownie is about one of the worst things we could have ever come across. Thank you, empty vessel. By the way, I want to point out that Gimpy has not paid out at all since we've gotten it. Our range looks like it's really good, too. It's going to go to the right and then up. Yeah, our tears rate is legit good right now. There's literally nothing. That was Kidney Stone screwing us over because it wouldn't fire. Is it gonna come down to Thunder Thighs? I wonder. I'm hoping I can just zerg down Blue Baby and just not have to worry about it. Infestation 2 is huge. That is a big time get for Team Isaac Victa here. I have no idea where the other one is. You know what? We're just gonna back up over here. How about that? Oh! I don't know why he came from that side, but... Oh my goodness, our movement speed. Oh, holy shot! Or holy light, I should say. Holy light. I think we can do it. We're just gonna do it. I'm gonna walk forward to try to deflect as many shots as possible and go in with a sack dagger. We did it. Oh man, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that one. That was another clincher, but hey, you know what? We showed heart, and with Isaac's heart, we did it. We did it the hard way. Rip MP's Brimstone, but I'll take it. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a fantastic day. Thank you for the support. I do appreciate it as well. And of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!